Happy New Year and welcome to the world where the international oil price has now hit $100 a barrel, predicted by some to be as high as 110 by the end of 2008. And of course the New Zealand pump price is going up by about 5 cents a litre just in the last couple of days, with more rises predicted. This poses an interesting quandary for New Zealand. We, like many other countries in the world, in fact all other countries in the world, are still highly reliant on hydrocarbon and hydrocarbon fuels for energy inside our economy. Yet we know that we are making big efforts to try and reduce our CO2 emissions in order that we play our part in sorting out climate change. What we do also know is that it's estimated that around the continental shelf of New Zealand and on mainland New Zealand there are some 24 billion barrels of oil equivalent deep inside the strata of this country that we think should be accessed so that our self-sufficiency around the hydrocarbon economy is greatly improved. The reality is that all countries of the world are going to continue using oil and gas for many, many years to come. And while we do want to see alternate fuels put in place, their replacement of oil is going to be slow. And as the Arab oil sheikh once said, just as the Stone Age didn't end because of a lack of stone, the oil age won't end for a lack of oil. So we think the government, which has recently produced the energy strategy, which has really no future indicated for gas or oil inside our economy, need to review that. Otherwise, those who are involved in the hydrocarbon industry are going to see New Zealand as a pretty poor bet. When you've got the sort of reserves we have, that's to say the least sad. And what it will mean is that you and I and every other user will pay very, very dearly just to stay warm, to have transport, and for that matter, to cook our food.